until it's too late.
Today,
I want to talk about bullies.
These videos, they insinuate that Romeo was the one bullying her.
What?
Look, I managed to get an appointment to visit Brent today, see if he can dissuade his mother from releasing these awful videos.
Right. Why are you looking at me like that?
I was wondering if you might have a chat with Peri. See if you can find out anything and everything about the time she spent in Brent's basement.
But it wasn't a holiday. She was held hostage.
No, I know that. But, you know, if my meeting with Brent doesn't go well, I'm going to need all the information I can get. And sadly, Peri does know him best.
Stop right there. I'm not doing it. She's traumatized enough. She's barely leaving the house.
Well, you know, but Cheryl has really upped the ante by releasing these videos. If no one admits to the murder, the police are going to build a case against someone, and possibly the wrong someone.
Romeo.
Or Peri.
What? Peri can't get sent down for this.
Precisely. That's why we need to make Brent confess to Rayne's murder.
James is gutted. Rayne's making out that Romeo bullied her. When in actual fact...
She's the one that bullied him. Worse than bullying, even.
You knew?
Yeah. We all found out at the house, but it just wasn't my secret to tell. Anyway, why have you bought me this? You better not be wanting me to talk about Brent. I've had enough of that from Mum already.
No. I just wanted to give you a treat, that's all. I'm not stupid, am I? No, you wouldn't want to rake over all that stuff. It sounded traumatizing.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it must have been awful. You know, being trapped in that basement for days.
It was.
Did he shove a tray of food down the stairs every now and again?
Steve! Stop! It was horrific, okay? Can you go and make us a brew?
I thought I heard you.
Come here. Has she mentioned to you anything about what happened with Brent?
No. Do you want to talk about it? She says she's 100% sure that he didn't kill Rayne. And she actually seems to like him.
Oh, well, someone's in a rush.
Well, got my physical to finally get a fire service. Today's the day, people.
Yay! Oh. Good luck. Right, hurry up, you're going to be late.
Yeah, hopefully we can celebrate later.
See ya.
Yeah, go smash it.
Cheers.
No, I don't get why she's trying to protect the person who literally kidnapped her.
Listen, she said he's actually really harmless and that Rayne's the one who messed him up. You know, the weird thing is, she's been having these nightmares, like waking up in the middle of the night and shouting and really disturbing. Almost like she's possessed.
What do you think that means?
It doesn't mean I did it.
Afternoon. My name's James
Nightingale. I know. Did my research when I heard you were visiting. You're a lawyer.
Very good.
You're also Romeo's dad.
As a result, I can't represent you, but I can advise you.
Wouldn't want you to represent me anyway. According to my mum, your son's looking like the prime suspect.
You're the one in custody for Peri Lomax's kidnapping.
A bit different to murder.
Brent, the police, the media, Rayne's family, none of them will rest until someone is behind bars for her murder. All the evidence points to you being that man.
It doesn't, though. The evidence they thought they found in my car, it hasn't led me to anything.
Regardless, you need a proper defense. I can help.
How?
Well, firstly, you can get your mum to stop posting videos of Rayne from beyond the grave.
You don't like those, because they make Romeo look guilty, which he is. Now, why would I put a stop to that?
You are merely feeding the cult. The more oxygen you give them, the less the truth matters. I will work with your legal team to construct the best self-defense strategy.
I didn't kill Rayne. I loved her. Just you wait. Rayne's videos are going to turn the tide against Romeo. And pretty soon, he's going to be the one who's locked up where he belongs.
Ha ha!
I forgot you had a key.
Just celebrating me getting in the fire service.
Yeah.
Congrats.
You all right?
No, I'm just looking for Ste. I thought he might be here.
Oh, yeah, well, he was before. Pez got upset. She's a bit paranoid that everyone thinks she's the murderer. They went for a walk.
Yeah, well, as soon as Brent confesses, the rest of us can go on with our lives.
Well, Pez doesn't think he did it.
Well, who else is it going to be?
I'll go put the kettle on.
Yeah. Listen, Pez told me that Romeo's gone away for a few days. That you got him a counsellor. Listen, James, you're doing everything you can. You know that, don't you?
Thanks.
Listen, someone knows what happened that night. And the quicker they come forward, the quicker Romeo and Pez will be out of this mess. We've just got to hang in there, okay?
Yeah. I have nothing to say to a bunch of voyeuristic death ghouls. Goodbye. Stop filming me or I'll call the police.
Wonder what they'd do if they knew you visited Brent today.
It sort of slipped out.
The fact is, Brent's going down for Rayne's murder anyway. The media, that lot, they've thought he was guilty since day one. If I can convince his legal team to make him confess, he'll get a lighter sentence.
You're going to make Brent confess to Rayne's murder?
I hadn't told her that bit.
He's not a murderer.
Oh, but who is? Romeo?
No.
Pez, come on, let's get you home.
Don't pin this on him. He don't deserve it.
Come on, come on.
Yeah, I know. The last person you thought you'd hear from. Look, I need your help.
Yeah.
Romeo, hey, it's me.
You're right.
Look, I don't know what to do. Your dad's trying to get Brent sent down. He's doing everything he can to save you from suspicion.
Poor Brent.
I think he's gonna go to jail.
So, apparently, Brent has had a bit of a run-in at the prison.
What do you mean, a run-in?
Well, I don't know. But must have triggered something, because he's decided to plead guilty after all.
We're just sticking to the plan, right? Telling no one what we did to Rayne.
Are you sure you had nothing to do with it?
No. Well, I think he must actually be the murderer.
Well, that's a relief. Not that he got beat up, but...
No. But it will stop fingers pointing at Romeo.
It's the only way, Pez. Tell no one.
Tell no one. Just pray he doesn't get out there.